Hello, everybody. It's James, Living Gardens Homestead. This is my barn cat. I normally don't like cats, but this one in particular here, me and him's kind of got a little close. He stays in the barn, he catches the mice and the rats, and I appreciate that. So, yeah, he's a good little boy. But anyway, the reason I'm bringing this video is I wanted to talk to you about our jalapenos we grew this year. Now, I'm going to put a few pictures on here, or put a video on of our jalapeno plants that I just did. But that's after we've already picked, I don't know, maybe a bushel of jalapenos. But, I mean, our peppers did excellent this year. And anyway, she made cowboy candy. I think she made 60-some quarts of, or 60-some pints of cowboy candy, but she put her own little twist into it. She added pineapple to it. And we've give some out to the neighbors and give some out to friends, and they love it. They're wanting the recipe to it. So if I can talk her into it, I might talk her into giving the recipe over the YouTube here so that everyone can have a recipe to it. But anyway, I'm going to show you a video of our plants. Like I said, these we've already picked. And these plants are still loaded. And anyway, I've got some pictures on there of when we canned them. And like I said before, when we can a lot. Now, I got a video I'm putting on here for the plants we've got right now and the peppers that's still left on them. And I got pictures of the ones we canned and some pictures of that, and I'll try to put them on there. So, if you don't care, give us a thumbs up. Comment on the video if you want to. Hopefully I can talk her into getting out that recipe so that everybody can use it. But anyway, stay tuned and just stay on here and bear with me. And I'm trying to do my best I can with this. So you all enjoy it. Okay, these are our jalapenos that we planted this year. And they grew very bushy, and they did very well. Now, these that you'll be looking at here, these came on after we picked. And like I said, it might have been about a bushel that we picked off from here. And she made her cowboy candy with them. And the pineapple she added to it. It really did give it a good flavor. And but I was just showing you these plants here to show you I don't prune my pepper plants. I let them grow and I don't prune anything. And you can see that these pepper plants has really been producing. And a lot of people say they prune. To me, it slows them down. To me, if you prune them, you've slowed them down and you've made it take longer before you finally get your peppers. Now, peppers come in usually later in the year when it gets really hot. Usually plant in the spring, and you usually don't get no peppers until getting close to fall. But these peppers really produce. They really amazed me at how well they did. But these peppers you're looking at, these has came on since we have done our picking. And I'll show you here in a little bit. They got so heavy, one or two of my plants, they even fell over from all the weight of the peppers. And it's not these peppers that you're looking at now. It was the peppers that we picked off before. They were a lot bigger than this one I'm showing you. But anyway, I hope I can get her to give you all her recipe. and with that cowboy candy because everybody's asking for it. And this way I can just tell them, just check it out on YouTube and she's got the recipe on there. But anyway, I hope y'all are enjoying the video. Now, as soon as I can, this is the one here that was, fell over from all the peppers that it had on it. But I'm going to show you a picture of the cowboy candy she canned. And it turned out really pretty. And like I said, we had 60-some pints probably and a few quarts. And anyway, it's delicious. It's cowboy candy with a twist. And she put her own little twist into it.